Hello everyone. The game we're playing today is Stellaris, and it is a grand strategy game, and probably one of my most favorite strategy games. Now, like most Paradox Interactive games, it's quite hard. Understand the basics at first, as there's just a lot of stuff and you're bombarded with a lot of stuff at first. So we'll start. First thing, we'll just start a new game. I have not activated any of the DLC. They've all been disabled. And when you start a new game, you're met with a preset empire or an already built empire, and you can choose. Each empire has specific lore. If you want to go with the preset, or you can create a new empire. Now, most of these are cosmetics. This is cosmetic. Species name is cosmetic. Names and traits is actually an important trait for your species. Like this one will give you 15% jobs from food. So your species is working a food job, it will pretty much increase the profit of the food by 15%. And there's more of these types of boosts. Intelligent, which will increase your research. Unfortunately, there's more, and there's one that will increase your habitability for planets. Rapid breeders, which will increase its pop growth. And more. So I'll just click rapid breeders. Like I said, most of these are just cosmetics. And then origin. Proper signification is the default one. It'll just increase your resources, but each one has like a unique boost to your empire, and it's pretty much the origin of your empire. And there's a lot of these if you download the DLC. Each which could be role-playing or just a unique boost to your empire again. But like I said, we'll go with proper signification. That is the default one. Now, government and ethics. So ethics is pretty much how your government will be. Well, this is your authority or your actual government. You can go from dictator to democratic. And over here, for example, fanatic xenophile pretty much means they like aliens, while the opposite is fanatic xenophobe, which means they hate aliens. And there's, of course, more of these. And Matilaris pretty much means, I mean, you can read the description, but it's like they don't believe in anything. And the civics are unique boosts provided by your government. And usually they go with technocracy, something like that. And just choose a random one. Sure, alright. Like I said, you can read through them, see what boosts they provide. Empire name, again, cosmetic. Flag, cosmetic. Ship appearance, cosmetic. Ruler, and cosmetic. So, most important ones is the origin, government ethics, and traits. Everything else is just cosmetic. Now, I'm just going to choose a preset empire, one that seems useful. I guess we could go with the fanatic spiritualist, alright. Now, this is the options for your game. You can go for a huge galaxy, or medium, large. So just go with the medium size, it's the smallest. Spiral, like I said, you can add AI empires. Or not. And you can just mess around with these. Fallen empires are usually a max empire with max researched. And they're pretty much strong foes that awaken at the year after year 2300. So we have zero of those. Text traditions, like I said, a lot of options. Crisis Strain. And the crises are usually like the end boss. And you can even choose which one you want. Mid-game start year. Just a lot of options. And then difficulty. You can actually read the list of difficulty. Cadet being the easiest, and Grand Admiral being the hardest. Captain being the middle. Captain's pretty much the middle. So we'll go with Cadet, since I'm a bit. I mean, pretty much, but yeah. And again, more information, more things you can change. And Iron Man mode, if you have that on, the game is eligible for achievements. If you have it off, the game is not eligible for achievements, which means you can save your game periodically. So when you start your game, this usually gives you an overlay of your empire. When you start the game, you're viewing your home system. And we're going to check out the outlier real quick. This is your home, your empire capital planet, your shipyards, your military fleet, and your civilian ships, which is the construction of the science ship. So I'm going to zoom in using the wheel on the mouse. And we're going to zoom in into our shipyard. You can click on your shipyard. And the first thing we'll see is starbase defenses and shipyard. Shipyard would let you produce ships, from colony ships to military ships to construction and science ships. Defenses, you can build defenses around your starbase. The actual starbase, you can upgrade it, build unique modules and unique buildings on it. And that's pretty much it for that. And then for the unique civilian ships, we have the construction ship, which can build mining stations on top of resources. Select the construction ship, right click, and build a mining station. I know, ain't that cool? The science ship can explore the uncharted star system. So you right click and you click survey system, and if you want to survey multiple systems, you right click, hold shift, and survey another system. As long as you hold shift, you can pretty much stack these commands on top of each other. So now that we've explained those, we want to focus on our resources. Now there's a lot of resources, but the rest pretty much are currently unimportant in our explanation. First one is energy credits, minerals, food, summer goods, alloys, and yeah. In order to produce more resources, let's check out our planet. This is the capital planet. Decisions are unique stuff you can do, but the most important stuff are districts. The bigger the planet, the more districts you can build on it. Each district provides a specific boost. City, provide housing. Industrial, provide two types of jobs that produce two types of resources, consumer goods and alloys. Generator districts provide energy credits. Mining districts provide minerals, and agriculture provides food. And whatever resource you're short on, you can build more of those districts to increase that resource. Buildings are unique buildings you can build. Sadly, I have no minerals to build anything. Population just shows you how many people are working. So there's rulers, specialists, and workers. Workers are your most basic job, and it shows how many current workers there are in there. And it shows how many available jobs. Armies, You can build armies on your planet to deter invasions of enemy empires. But you don't have to worry about that. So, that's pretty much that. Alloys pretty much help you build ships and stuff like that. Influence is very useful. And it will increase after you colonize a couple more planets and your factions start to build up. Now that we explained a little bit of that up there, let's go into technology. So, technology is very useful boosts to your empire, right? So this one just increases your research station outputs, for example. If I can find one, it'll just increase this, it'll increase the amount of research that comes out of these deposits. There's three types of technology: physics, society, engineering. Engineering pretty much helps you in a lot of things. So I guess I can go for, this will increase the amount of minerals my jobs will produce. I can go for this one, which will provide a new type of military equipment type thing. Yeah, it's upgraded armor for my ships. Go for minerals. Society research. Go with this one. Energy credits. Meh, it's just, and the best way to increase research points is to build mining stations. That usually doesn't help that much. Or build a research station or research labs on your building slots. Let's see, I think I talked about most of the stuff with your planet system. That. So let me unpause that. Let me explain some of the tabs on the left. Leaders. Pretty much. I don't know. Let's just. Wait, I forgot to tell you one more thing. Always when you start a game, build a science ship. So you can explore the uncharted galaxy quicker. Oh, and also E is to pretty much exit out of your system, and you can just left click on a system to enter it. A bunch of icons will pop up here, notifying you of things. You can just right click them and they'll pretty much disappear. So, let's talk about these tabs on the left. The first one is your government tab. Like I said, it's just an overlay of government. Contacts will show all the contacts you have made. Right now I have made no contacts with anyone. The market, if you want, you can buy resources using your energy credits. Or sell resources to get energy credits. Planet sectors, a thing no one knows. Another thing that I don't understand. Policies. Define your governments, pretty much. Edicts are boosts.
Construction to complete.
Your government. Society management. When you produce enough unity, you will be able to unlock an ascension tree. Ship designers, fleet manager. For ship designer, fleet manager, you don't really have to understand those, as this one's automatic, so all your ships will be automatically upgraded. Technology that we talked about already. Factions that will currently not be here until we colonize a couple more planets. And our species list, which will show all the current species we have discovered. So, I think I relatively explained everything quite simply. One thing I forgot to explain is this right here. this will pretty much show the needs of your planet, show you the available jobs, crime rate, housing, current unemployment, and amenities. You have to focus on amenities sometimes, as if there's no amenities, your pops will be very unhappy. In order to build those, you usually build holo theaters. They'll just produce amenities, but they use up your consumer goods. And hey, we produce enough unity to lock a tradition. You can select a tradition, and when you fill out the perks of every tradition, you will unlock a ending effect. The adoption effects will pretty much be the effect you get when you select adopt, and when you activate all of these other slots, you will be able to get the finisher effects. So, let's see, the first one.
Construction complete.
Usually, prosperity will increase your resources. Harmony will pretty much help out your pops. It's either expansion or prosperity that is usually gotten first, or adaptability. As you produce more unity, you'll be able to unlock or, yeah, pretty much purchase one of these skills or slots. And ascension perks will pretty much be once you get 5 out of 5 and unlock all those little squares, you'll be able to get an ascension point. And with that ascension point, you'll be able to get one of these perks. Now, there's not that many, but when you do get the DLC, there'll be a couple more. What's my time? 3 minutes? Alright. That's as most as I can explain. Your main objective will be to just continue to explore until you find a galaxy. Now, you can conquer the galaxy, or you can live with the galaxy. I mean, I prefer conquering everything. It's just more easy. And let's see, where's my science ship? He's over there. Alright. This right here, this is a planet. A potential colonizable planet. I'll show you the size. Is that like a alpine world? Yeah, I don't think I can colonize that, but either way. Except your outlier is quite important. Show you your planets and your shipyards and your fleets. I haven't talked about your fleets yet, have I? So another thing that you have to build is your military fleets, as you can encounter enemy ships out there. So you build more, you get more firepower, and it's stronger. Quite simple. And I'm going to, in order to expand your color, and you fill up this whole entire section with your color, you have to go to your construction ship, right click on a star system, and click build starbase, which will require alloys and influence. And that's pretty much that. Oh, look at this, an event. So these are usually story driven events, and all they add is story and maybe a couple of boosts to one of your research points or resources. They're not actual boosts, they more likely will add a star system boost. Or they'll add points to your research. But yeah.
Situation log updated.
And one more thing. When you're viewing your planet, you can go on features, and sometimes these red little squares will block the amount of districts you can build, and to remove them, you'll just click clear blocker. Once they've been removed, they'll increase your max districts that you can build, because currently your max districts are being blocked by some of these blockers. Alright, disgusting, alright? Yeah. That's one thing I wanted to explain. Another thing that popped up is an anomaly, which will Well, more specifically, there are 5 pre-galactic civilizations that have somehow disappeared, and you will get one of those 5s. I got the Yacht Empire. Not explain what they are, but they're a type of anomaly that you can research, and once you find their homeworld planet, you'll be able to get like a unique boost. So they're quite useful to do, but they're quite hard to do as their anomalies are usually of the highest level and require a scientist of high level. So you better have your scientists survey a lot of systems if you want them to level up and do these prehistoric empire anomalies. Hey there, it's the Magnificent Jim. Well, that's the end of the video. This is more of like a guide to how to play Stellaris, but I'm not as nearly experienced as these other Stellaris YouTubers are. For instance, Aspec, he's a nice YouTuber. His content is amazing. It's very well detailed compared to this. But if you made it this far, like and subscribe, and have a good day.